Hello there, you frickin' space captain jizz. It's Connor, and welcome back to another Fractured Space ship overview. Right, today we'll be looking at the TDS support craft, the Protector, which I have really, really mixed feelings about. Mainly because I grew up watching, like, Star Trek, The Next Generation, the original Star Trek, Star Wars, Starship Troopers, recently Battlestar Galactica, Halo movies and stuff that are currently coming out as well, Farscape, Stargate, pretty much every series that is related to any of them, including Firefly as well. And I was obsessed with space battles, like the ships, the designs of the ships, how they looked aesthetically and things. But never before have I, in any of those universes, and some of those universes are pretty freaking out there, by the way, have I seen a ship that actually can replace entire chunks of hull damage with a green beam. Now, I've seen people use the excuse, well, it transfers nanobots that repair the ship. But the nanobots need material to replace the material on the ship that was lost, like the wiring and the internal system. So how does this thing work? It doesn't make any sense. I mean, this is in the game, and the most logical excuse or reason that I can come up with is a wizard did it. A wizard is channeling, three wizards are channeling a green beam that heals the enemy, or heals your ally, sorry, not your enemy. That would be ridiculous. I mean, this ship is ridiculous to begin with. But on the other hand, I enjoy playing it. Now, people don't enjoy playing with me because I play this ship a lot differently than the boring, very boring way that most people play it, which is sitting at the back line and just imagine it was like four ships way up here and you are just move over to the left a little bit to dodge some incoming fire. Then healing everybody. It's a boring ship. Now, I've spoke to people who have played the game for years, and they say it's a ship they play a lot just so they can help the whatever team they play with win, because they're good healers. But it's boring. A ship shouldn't be that boring, and I try to play it in a way that's fun, because I like playing a game because I play a game for fun. That's, is that not why games were invented? Is that not what they're for? But I enjoy playing the ship in my own personal playstyle. But you know what? Let's get through the stats and the loadout, then we'll jump into a game. I'll explain a little bit more. So the base hull strength is 6,000, which is actually the lowest of all the TDS support craft. At the Sentinel, we have 9,000 hull strength, which is the highest, I believe. We have the Basilisk here, which is 8,000. Now, is there any of these? I don't have the equalizer. Okay, what does the equalizer have? Right, so the equalizer has a little bit more health, but it's about the same speed. And going on to speed, the Sentinel has 580, and the Basilisk has a respectable 615 initial max speed. The Protector and the Equalizer both have 660 initial max speed, which is quite fast. I mean, this thing's quite nimble and agile, but for its shape, it's just a weird shape. I mean, look at it. It's real wide, and it looks real cumbersome, and it doesn't maneuver well in between asteroids and stations if you're trying to, like, outmaneuver the enemy. I mean, a ship like the Interceptor or the Reaper is really, really fucking good at that. It really is hiding behind stuff and just getting behind cover. This thing, you bang into stuff and you get caught in things a lot. It just doesn't, it's fast, but it doesn't maneuver well, if you know what I mean. But yeah, this bit of information is out of date, so I'll just skip that. Let's get on to the abilities. Smart Gun, I'm going to just do a quick overview of these abilities. Actually, you know what, let's see if we can find a game while we're doing that. So, loadout. Smart Gun, it's a weapon that tracks the enemy. Once you fire it, whoever's targeted, you pretty much got your light one here and your heavy one. Pretty much the same with all weapons. Again, with the repair beam, which is the ability you're going to be pretty much used for in the game. That's what you want to be keeping your allies up with and stuff. There are three available. The quick one that does a quick burst of healing, which is really, really low, but it cools down really quickly. Then the one that takes a long time to cool down, but does a massive bit of healing. I went with the base one just because I'm more comfortable with it. In fact, I'm going to jump over to the quick one here just to try it out a little bit more. I tried it out for a couple of games. Wasn't really sure what I thought about it. The defensive field, it's pretty much a shield that's around you for a 3,500 meter radius. Anybody inside that will have damage reduced by 50% for 20 seconds. So keep close to your allies with this one. This one, the defensive bubble is one you deploy. Does the same thing. But I prefer the defensive field that surrounds me, so I'm able to maneuver the shield and get to allies that need it. These are your abilities that shut down an enemy system. So this one shuts down their abilities. So that would be my defensive field and my repair beam. I wouldn't be able to use them for 15 seconds or something. I have the disarm, which pretty much disables the enemy's weapons. So like my smart gun or my I'm not even sure if the Lamprey drones count. But I use this a lot. It stops the enemy from firing their weapons for 6 seconds, which allows me or my ally to jump out. Gives them and me enough time to do that, so it's really good for escapes. And ability torpedo, you can read the information now yourself if you pause the video. I don't really think it has any use right now. One of the most important abilities on the ship, the Lamprey drones, which drain energy from the enemy ships for about 45 seconds and transfer it back to you. So this is crucial, because you run out of energy fast when healing and using all these abilities, so it's really important to use the Lamprey drones. But that's pretty much it. I've also changed my crew over. This is the Nubs. Not really sure what I did with him. I think it was for more speed and maneuverability and stuff, so yeah. As well as cooldown, I think. But yeah, I was in a game there. And, you know, I was playing the Protector the way I like to play it. The team, we had lost from the start. Our watchman didn't know what he was doing. We had an interceptor on the team, didn't know what he was doing either. Then we had a Leviathan who wasn't that bad. I wouldn't say he's HE3 level of good. I mean, those guys are really, really awesome. But he wasn't amazing either. And he kept blaming me for deaths and stuff, even though they kept getting themselves into stupid situations. And I was healing. I got quite a few support points there, and I was dying because they weren't really focusing down targets. I mean, I try to stay at the back and heal, but sometimes I move forward to try and protect allies with the shield or whatever. Maybe I shouldn't do that, but I do it. It's just instinct to move forward and help somebody. Again, I come from playing ships like the Interceptor, the Reaper. These are two of my favorite attack craft, and I play them very aggressively. Whereas this thing, it's best played in the back lines, just healing up allies, which is boring. Very boring to me. So, yeah, you'll probably see not much going on in this game. Hopefully everyone accepts. There we go. Because, well, you know what a Protector does? It just heals. It's nothing important or nothing special, really. I enjoy playing it sometimes. I have had some of my best games in the thing, just the most enjoyable games. Some of the best crutch games, or whatever the kids call them today. I used to call them tight back in my day, where the situation was really tight. We didn't know if we were going to win or lose, and we came out the victor. So, everybody ready up? Let's see what we got. Well, I'm the only support in the team, hopefully. Until we get switched over. Yep, I'm the only support. Awesome. Let's greet everyone. Hello, everyone. Best of luck. Right, so who am I going to stay with here? What have we got? We got a Ghost Cipher in his Raven. 10 OS in his Pioneer. Emosiak in his Colossus, and KD in his Reaper. I would really prefer being in an interceptor or something in this game. And I accidentally hit the shields. Can I disable the shields? I don't think so. I've been trying to do it all night. I've been up all night trying to record this video. Haven't had any good games so far. It's hard to get a good game in this thing, because it's not like I'm going to get a lot of kills or anything in it. I mean, this fucking smart gun is bloody useless. So, Damosiak, where's he jumping to? Alpha 1. Let's jump to Alpha. Where's everyone jumping? Alpha? Jump to Alpha then. So, prepare yourselves for some legit MLG. Whoa, fuck. MLG gameplay here in the Protector. Now, I tend to get really ahead of myself in this thing just because of the speed. I don't want to stop it for some reason. I really get used to the speed really quickly. Right, he's moving down. Pioneer moving forward, so I'm going to move forward just a little bit here. See what they've got, a Colossus and a Venturer, okay. Oh wow, he's aggressive. A little bit of comedic chat going on there in the old chat box. Oh fuck. Dude, why are you so far ahead? Maybe I shouldn't have went with a burst one. Dude, why did you push so forward? Dude, why did you push? Right, so I'm going to continue firing here and look, see how they track on. Which means if he gets under fire, then I can just heal him up. Keep going. Amosiak. Keep up the attack. See how it gets caught and everything? It's such a wide ship. Alright, so it looks like B is getting pushed pretty heavily. Three enemy ships pushing against two of ours. Oh, he's jumping home. Come on, get him. Yeah, yeah, I get it. I need upgrades too. Upgrades, exactly. Disarm him. Just for the hell of it. Keep firing, dude. I got your back. Don't worry about it. Let's hit his bottom. There he comes. The Art Pioneer's back for a fight, lads. Back for a scrap. That's what I like to see. Get his bottom repaired there. There we go. All fixed. Someone just jumped. There he is. Engage the defensive field. Ah, he's going for me. He's going for me. I need to get out of here. I need to get out of here fast. Use the speed of this thing to get ourselves out of here. Come on. I'm fucked here. Right. Now, in the last game I played, similar situations to that where I was helping, but I got their attention. So they all came after me. I was being blamed for not playing right because I should be invisible and healing without them noticing me. So, fuck you, dude. Can't remember your name. It was something really pretentious, like dark shadows in the night. My soul is empty, but my love for you is full, or some bullshit like that. Axe, by the way, beside the start and the end there of his name. Alright, let's go to B and help push B. I like pushing a bit of B. Feels good. Upgrades. The bane of my existence. What the hell would ever fit through that hole there? Maybe the, would the Interceptor fit through? It's an awful thin ship now. Let's get up here. Alright, Mr. Redface. Let's go. Multiple enemy targets. Deploy Lamprey drones. Let's start draining those bastards. I'm not even in range of healing him, am I? Why am? Healing up the Raven. Come on, keep up the heals. Come on. See, our Colossus has got a massive hard on for me, look. You see, people like to blame healers in games for getting killed, pretty much. It was the same whenever I played WoW, even whenever I tanked or whenever I DPSed. They DPSed a lot more than they did anything else. People used to blame healers for everything. I'm going to pull out here while he's disarmed. And the Protector jumps out double the speed because he's got a special engine or some nonsense. We've lost Gamma. Sorry, I wasn't paying enough attention. I was in combat. So I'm going to jump to Alpha. Get into that cap and level up. Yep, level 5 now. Let's get this done. So yeah, there is a lot of burden put on the shoulders of healers. People think that healers are like gods that can keep them alive constantly, and whenever they die, it's because the guy wasn't paying attention or he sucked. Alright, let's go. Let's get into that cap and start getting some mains. How much? We're actually behind in XP or whatever you call it here. So let's descend here. Let's get these mains. Any enemy presence yet? Oh, yep, Protector. Quite a high ping on this map. Where is it? Oh, Asia. Jesus. It's strange. I mean, it allows you to tick different servers, but I don't have Asia's picked. That's weird, and I don't think many people here are from bloody Asia. So why are we on the Asian server? Matchmaking in Fractured Space is definitely strange, to say the least. Protector's still there. Yep, Protector's still there. Deploy our Lamprey drones. Drain his energy just to piss him off. Don't all go air. Why is everyone going air? It's the fucking follow the leader, is it? Alright, I'm on my way. Jumping behind, what's his name? R.O. Dollar Dollar Keddy. Right, here we go. Okay, he's pushing forward. Looks like they're all pulling back to defend air. I should probably be there. Emo Siak is inactive and will be kicked. Of course, there's always a fucking AFK DC player on a game. Well, not even a player, because he's not playing. Hopefully he will rejoin. I doubt it because it never happens. It happens maybe 10% of the time that somebody reconnects. Come on, Emo Siak.
Get to a station. An upgrade is available.
I found him.
Okay, that bastard's here. I'm getting back because he has a hard on for me, a massive one. Commandante. I can send my drones after him though. That'll work. See? Forcer. Disarm him. He's below us, dude. He's below us. This is not good. This is not good. This is not good. Okay, Ross doesn't take any damage. That's good. Ah, you fucker, you. Fuck. Yep, I didn't think this was going to be another entertaining game. The Protector games that I've recorded are just dull and boring and, well, not entertaining in the slightest. So, this is probably going to be the most boring overview video I've done. And again, I don't hate the ship personally. I personally hate a 3D model. I don't hate the actual ship itself. I hate the idea of a ship like this in this universe. It doesn't fit in. It just seems like fucking wizards are using, I don't know, rejuvenation or some healing shit. See AFK as well. Go safer. Well, this is a brilliant game. Stop bitching and play, ladies. For fuck's sake. Well, if you're fucking Raven, play a different ship, because you obviously aren't fucking good in it. Where is he? 2 kills, Will, he's the best in the team. He's got 2 kills. Even I have a kill. What the hell's going on there? You see teams like this far too often in this game. Far too often. How'd that miss? That hit him. Come on, ah, you fucker, you. Well, guys, I've been going all night, and I literally mean all night and morning, trying to get this video up, get a good video recorded. Oh, they look awesome. They're gorgeous missiles. They really, really look cool. Gonna have to try and get the Raven. I mean, it's a weird looking ship. It looks like the Protector crossed with the what's that ship? The Equalizer or something? I don't know. It's weird. It looks like a pod racer. Now this is pod racing. But yeah, I have yet to have a decent or entertaining Protector game in like 2 days. So I apologize about this. This is the best currently that I could get, where I was able to do actual some healing and. Oh, Jesus Christ, guys. For fuck's sake, guys. Too much whining. Oh, you know what? I got a good joke here. Want some red with your wine? Brilliant joke, I have to say. Come on, you get it. Fucking hell, this beam. Oh my god, nobody's getting along. I hate it when nobody gets along. The teams don't get along, don't get the win. It is fated. It was foretold by the elders. Those that are salty get no win. Right, here we go. Air protector jumping in. He's no problem. He should be able to get taken down pretty easily. Fuck. Oh, those sneaky hits. I need to heal somebody. Where's the Raven? Ah, shit, I've been deactivated or stunned or whatever it's called. Shit. Come on, get him down. Get him down. Faster, lads, come on. He's down. Good stuff. Get the Venture now. Get some heals out. I am playing horribly here. I really am. Shit. If any of you guys in the game I am currently playing with, I mean, Go Safer, 10OS, Amosiak, or RO Dollar Dollar Kitty, watch this. Please maybe stay quiet in games where they're not going so well and just try to help each other out. Otherwise, it ends up like this. A complete and utter mess. Where you just get your ass handed to you constantly. Because you're not working together. Embarrassing. I mean, the community is small enough without people whining and bitching and doing constant stuff like this. Try to help people out. It's a small community. Come on. Right, jump in here. Let's get this back quickly as possible. They've got a level on us and everything. They'll be level 9 by the time we're level 8. Well, here's hoping they don't. My math could be slightly off. I'm not a scientist after all. Start getting these mines. Gamma in 54 seconds? Seriously? We have no chance of getting that. Not a chance in hell. Brawler down there. He doesn't seem too interested. Is he going to Gamma? No, he's not too interested. Dude, what are you doing? You haven't got the range, buddy. You haven't got the range. You adult, you. We have to control this location. Target ran. Is anybody going to Gamma? Yep. Nobody else coming to Gamma? Nobody? Let's go, dude. We can do this. We can do it. We have the power. We have the technology. We have the green beam of bullshit. We have wizards. We have magic. You're a wizard protector. I'm being aggressive. What am I doing? You're disarmed, buddy. Oh, so am I. Shit. It seems you had countered my counter. Ingenious play, my friend. Let's get out of here. Raven's really fucking cowardly. We got this, lads. We got this. Just keep together. Shit, we got a guy on me. I gotta get out of here. Come on. Please don't disable me. Shit, he got me before I could get him. Dude, sorry, I can't heal you. He's fucking me up, this bloody Colossus. I want to see what he says, if he does reply. What's his name? Where is he? Commandante. Every time he comes in, he just tries to kill me. Every time he sees me, he goes straight through the battle lines to get to me. I mean, they'll take your heart on. Don't worry about that there. I'm not shy. But just ask me first. Two Colossuses. Colossi. Do they have two Colossi? It's hard to deal with. Oh, this is our Colossus I'm watching. Is he actually going to make it, is he? Maybe. Yep, he got out. Good stuff, lad. Good stuff. M-O-C-H. Just moving my chair a wee bit closer to the mic. Right, he is burning up. I'm going to jump to... Let's get to beta. Little bit of beta. Beta, beta. Beep, 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 beep. Yeah, really, it's the new award, and it's Gregory Dravenov. I have a sneaking suspicion that maybe Commandante does not speak English. Mainly, but fucking hell, where are all these guys going to the same place for? Gotta get over there and help my buddy in the Isle Colossus. I'm on my way. What's his name? I'm on my way to help little Emosiak. I'm a terrible singer. Can't even come up with lyrics that quick. Now we've got our guys here. We've got Raven and Colossus. Why do I not feel confident? Dudes, just do what you do. I'll back you up 100% of the way. Why didn't I repair that? Did I not get it dead on? Hold on. There we go. Get our disarmed drones out there. Let's just stay at the back a little bit. Get our guys up. See, I've still got my target set on the Venture, so even if I name them down here, they'll fly towards him, the smart gun. Get that guy. Get him. He's the one that also has a hard on for me. Ah, damn upgrades. We have upgrades waiting, sir. Take us in, number one. Take us in for upgrades. Who's he calling shit? Let's just put this guy in his place. Oh dear. We may have a problem. Come on, dude. Look at all that damage being done to him, that is crazy. Going back to base, and then going to Alpha. Was hoping for a pleasant game. Holy shit. Emosiak is dealing with horrible lag and he's kicking ass like he is. Jesus Christ. See all this bitch just because we can't. Where'd your weapons go now? Yeah, big, brave, dirty, bloody Zarek ship you. It's a brick of a ship. I mean, look at it. It's pretty much brick-shaped. There's no design or beauty to it at all. Destroy I need to get closer to him, otherwise he'll jump out. Look at the dodging maneuvers and everything here. Look at that. Look at the freaking strafing. I'm like a freaking... What's really good at strafing? I have no idea. I'm like one of them Ultron bikes that just turns really fast. Look at that. Look at the speed of that turn. Look at that. So agile. It's ridiculous. The speed this thing has. Alright. Okay, I have some weird outbursts. R.O.$KD. Say hello to YouTube. Say hello to the YouTube community. Say hello to the Fractured Space community that will be watching this. OEDC'd. Good stuff. He must have got embarrassed and didn't know how to handle himself, so he left. And there'll probably be a dislike in this video. I wonder where it came from. I'll R.O.$KD. They got Gamma. Doesn't matter. We're not going to be able to win this with a player down. Well, about 200 of yous. We'll see this. About 200 people. We'll see this video on know to report him. Hopefully if he does the same thing again. Oh, shit. Come on, get behind cover. I need to jump out. I'm not in the right position here at all. Come on. No. What's he go? Come on. I don't know what I'm doing. My controls are all messed up here for some reason. There we go. Come on, get back to base. Damn it! He did start it. R.O.$KD. Ah, Fractured Space. The community is getting so charming lately. I need sleep. I really need sleep. Not sleeping during the day, hell no. R.O.$KD. I mean, that KD is definitely nothing to do with his kill death ratio because 3 kills and 7 deaths. And a Reaper. And one of the best attack craft in the game. He got 3 kills. And 7 deaths. Fuck, I got 5 kills. I got more kills than him. And a protector. And I got 4 supports. Oh, I am awesome. I mean, I suck on the protector. That was blatantly obvious from the game. I chose a totally wrong healing thingamajig. But, yeah. Interesting game, some interesting characters. I'd like to thank, 10OS for showing up. He's level 3, he didn't do that badly. I mean, fuck, he got 10 deaths. But he got 5 kills, he got more than the pro here. R.O.$KD. Gross Cypher in the Raven, did awesome. Myself, well, let's not mention me. I mean, Mike freaking MMR's dropped almost 300 in the past couple of games. Abusiak, awesome as well in his Colossus, not to forget the enemy team. Commandante, 17 kills, 7 of which were me, or 6 of which were me. The Isle Outburst Racist, with Tourette's and Adventure, 11 kills, Hilltop and his Enforcer, 12 kills, so they pretty much dominated us from the start. But there you go, that was an interesting game, just going to boost the XP here. I've got a couple of these things left, so may as well use them. And that was the TDS Protector, the healer of the fleet. The protector of the fleet, if you will. Not a ship I personally like in the game, just, you know, for immersion reasons. But it's going to stay here, I assume. And I do enjoy it in games at times. It is a really enjoyable ship if you like healing. So there it is. Thank you all very much for watching. If you would like to support me and the channel, just go to the link below and you can do so. As always, I'll see you next time, guys. Bye-bye.